And we should be live on Spreaker and iHeartRadio as well. Good evening to everyone here. Welcome aboard to the Leadership TKO Live Night Show. I'm your host, leadership specialist, wealth mentor, author, Lakeisha McKnight. And so it's 7:21 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on this Friday, July the 31st. It's the final month, the final day in the month of July. And so hopefully you've had an amazing month. I know that I've had an amazing month, right? And I'm just only expecting it to get greater from here. Whoop! It's going to go way up. That's right. Nothing can stop us. We all the way up, as they would say. So listen, I'm so glad to be here tonight. I really am. This show goes live every single night around 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And so listen, I'm going to be sharing with you some great information on tonight. Something in my eye. So we invite you to definitely plug in as often as you can to the show. The purpose of the show really is to empower leaders like yourself with the ability to win from the inside out, growing your influence, your impact, and your income. Okay? Influence, impact, and income. And so you all know, right? Every single day, we're coming together. We're providing you all with some great content, great information. And so one of the things, of course, that I'm going to share with you tonight is something powerful. I'm going to give you an appetizer. That's right. You already know I give you appetizers at the beginning of the show. And so we're going to go ahead and I'm going to share with you my screen so you'll see exactly what I see. Let me pull it up real quick. Here we go. Perfecto. So we're going to go over this appetizer. Give me one quick second and we're going to go right over it. 1 second, guys. Grabbing a powerful resource for you guys. All right. So we are back. So look, here's the appetizer that I do want to share with you first and foremost. And this is the law of curiosity. The law of curiosity. Now, before we dive into it, feel free, okay, to share this on to your timelines and other relevant places where it can help not only just yourself, but help others to grow and to enhance their leadership ability. And so this law is the law of curiosity. The law of curiosity. And it simply says this: growth is stimulated by asking why. You know, a lot of times we get involved with things, we become connected with things, but we don't ask the essential question. Why? Okay. So how do we cultivate curiosity? How do we do that? You see, the following are just some suggestions, you know, that you can really engage in to cultivate curiosity. And so the first one is this: you want to believe you can be curious. I know it sounds simple, right? But trust me, these steps right here is not simple for everyone. So the first step, believe you can be curious. Secondly, have a beginner's mindset. Okay, don't assume that you know it all, but just come in there with an open slate, ready to learn. Third, make why your favorite word. I know. Listen, it may sound a little silly, I get it, but let it become your favorite word. Why? Someone recommends a book to you. Why? Why should you read it? Somebody gives you an audio to listen to. Why? Why should you listen to it? Someone wants to invite you to come somewhere. Why? Why should you go? So make why your favorite word, okay? And then fourth, you want to spend time with other curious people. Yeah, I'm one of the most curious people out there because I'm going to ask why. I'm going to ask what's in it, especially when it comes to food. What's in it? What is in this? I need to know what I'm eating, okay? Now, I'm not one of those that's kind of like a little annoying with it, but I am going to ask questions. Okay. Fifth point, learn something new every day. That, I mean, I love that. Like, I'm like, okay, well, when you wake up in the morning, what is it that I'm going to glean today? What am I going to get from today? Like, I'm super pumped and stoked. I'm like, okay, Lord, what is it? What have I come to learn today? What is it that you want me to get today, receive today? Learn something new. Be intentional. Even if it means learning from your children, my goodness, they can be infants coming out of the womb and teach you something. You just have to have an open mind to receive it. Sometimes we pacify things. They're like, oh, she's crying. Oh, she's doing that. Or he's doing that. Right? Why? Ask yourself the question, why? Why do kids play with their toys the way that they play with them? Okay? Why do they do the certain things that they do? Okay. Point six, partake in the fruit of failure. Notice we have it phrased fruit of failure. Something comes forth from failure, huh? Something good? It says fruit. Mm-hmm. Point seven, stop looking for the right answer. We're so used to this. Oh my goodness. Going to school with that formal education system. You know, got to get the right answer. Hey, how about, you know, inquiring about all answers? Why are these suggested answers? Why is that answer not the correct answer? Why? Be curious, okay? Be curious. And then finally, point eight, get over yourself. Some of us, we just got to tell ourselves and remind ourselves, it ain't about you, boo. Right? Put it in those terms. Put it plain, okay? Get over yourself. It's not about you. All right? It's about the team. It's about winning together. It's about doing something amazing together. I like this quote by Dorothy Parker. She says, the cure for boredom is curiosity. There is no cure for curiosity. There's no cure. Everyone is going to keep on asking why, right? So there is no cure. Love this quote. It's amazing. It's amazing, guys. So listen. Look at this right here. Replace fear of the unknown with curiosity. Curiosity. You want to do that, okay? Ask the questions. You learn so much more. You have a more fulfilling life. Okay? And so this is the law of curiosity, everyone. Growth is stimulated by asking why. Asking why. And I'm hoping, of course, that you've enjoyed our appetizer. That's right. You know, we got to hit you up with an appetizer at the beginning of each session. That's right. Each show, we're going to give you a nugget. We want to help you to grow your leadership ability. Most people, let me just go back to the law of the lid. I hear the law of the lid share so much time, you know, people raising your lid. It depends on how, you know, what the context that it's used in. And you really need to understand what the law of the lid is saying. It just simply says that your effectiveness, your ability to lead effectively is enhanced when you grow. Your ability to lead effectively, your ability to succeed is based on your ability to lead. So listen, if you're not leading well and working on yourself as far as personal development, listen, your lid may stay right here. And then your business might stay right here. Your business, your ability to be a mom, your ability to be a father, your ability to do various things are just going to stay right here. It's never going to supersede your lid, your leadership lid. It's going to keep on hitting this particular roof right here, the ceiling. It can't go beyond your ability to lead. But if you expand yourself and cause yourself to grow, right? Implementing these invaluable laws of growth, guess what? Raise that lid even higher. Okay, we'll move it over. Raise it higher and even higher. And guess what? The success within your business, right? Or being a parent would raise and actually increase as well. Again, what you do, the areas that you want to thrive in and succeed in, when it comes to the law of the lid, it's based on your ability to lead. And that is what the law of the lid is all about. I can go over the law of the lid. I love that law. I love that law. And John Maxwell, I'm telling you, he drills it home. Every time we have sessions, he's just like, look, that lid, you working on your lid? And I'm like, yes, sir. Yes, sir. And so, guys, I appreciate you, you know, still being plugged in right here, but I want to get into the main meal. Y'all ready for the main meal? I'm ready to get into this main meal. Now, I've been diving into some concepts from my network marketing mentor's book, one of their books that they published many, many years ago. And this is 103 Ways to Fail in Network Marketing, A Guide to Your Success, authored by Mrs. Valerie and Ty Best. Okay, 103 ways to fail in network marketing. So listen, if you want to succeed in this profession, because that's what it is, the network marketing profession. You can be a home-based business owner and have the ability to share, you know, your opportunity with other people and help people plug in. And then you get commissions and then you have all this great goodness going on. Well, the nuggets in this book is going to help you avoid some common pitfalls, some common holes. You want to avoid these major holes in the road that's going to cause damage to your business. And so let's dive into it, because tonight I do want to get into this one. I read this one. I was like, oh, I wonder how many people knew this one. Okay. I was just like, okay, when I get into this one, I know it's going to cause some people to say, right? These are not things that we think about. Let's get into it. The 17th way to fail in network marketing is this. If you are not married, I repeat, if you are not married, date or marry someone who has no interest or hates the network marketing business, except when they see immediate money and rewards. The battles you are left to fight are on your own. I mean, it really is. Okay, again, I'm repeating, if you're not married now, you date or you marry someone who has no interest or hates the network marketing business, except when they see immediate money and results. Okay, here's what they say furthermore, the best. I know this sounds hard and somewhat fanatical, but if you are a single person and your goal is to build a profitable network marketing business, then your choice of companionship becomes an addiction, or I should say not addiction, addition to your business, or a distraction. Either it's going to become an addition or a distraction, okay? If they're not interested in the business when you are dating, what makes you think they're going to be interested after you're married? Many people may find you interesting once you become financially successful. Remember the journey and those who traveled with you. And this is a journey. You know, this profession is a lifestyle. It really, really is. It's something that you go after every single day. You don't pick it up and lay it down. You pick it up and you keep running. It's a marathon. That's what the network marketing profession is all about. It's a marathon. You wake up by God's grace and you keep running. You keep running towards fulfilling not just your dream, but helping those around you, those that you're mentoring. The more you serve and help others to get what they want, guess what? You're going to get what you want by default. It's just the way that it is. It's just the way that the universe works. You're going to get exactly what you want. Help and serve more people. Serve more. But in order for you to serve more, you got to be more. In order for you to be more, guess what? You need to intake more. What do we intake more? We got to intake more content. Okay. You got to get more of this inside of your psyche. You got to transform yourself, you know, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. That's what you need to do. Transform yourself through reading, by getting mentorship and coaching and videos and audio. All of these essential things is going to help you to become better, to transform. Because look, there's a different mindset when it comes to being an employee versus being in this profession. It really is. Most people who are employed, they're so used to someone telling them what to do, what tasks they got to fulfill. But for those in the network marketing space, you have to get up and determine and say, these are the things that I have to do and get done and go do them to get the results that you're looking to get. Okay, that's just the way that it is. Most people are just, they just want everything to come to them. Tell me what to do. What do I get? Let me get a paycheck. And they go running after it each time. Now, here it is. Here's what I do want to say. I'm not bashing being employed or having a job. But you do want to put a time frame on that, especially if you're running after freedom. Okay. And I love, of course, the Best Household. They have, I mean, if you want to learn about this profession and how to really attain freedom, the Best Household personifies it simply because in their home, there's over 100 years of freedom. And I would learn from someone who has already been there. Okay. Who's doing it. Right. That is, I'm telling you, copy the right people, the people who have gotten the results there where you want to be, copy them. And my husband and I, we are running with them. Why? You know, they're married, we're married. They have children, we have children. You know, we're definitely looking and learning We're watching what they're doing and doing what they're doing. And that's how we get the results that they are getting. Okay. And so listen, again, the 17th way to fail in network marketing. If you're not married, date or marry someone who's not interested or even hates the network marketing profession. So what do you need to do in your conversation when you're dating? Okay. In your conversation, even at that dating phase, that courting phase, ask the question about career and your future. Now, sometimes things do change along the way. Okay, you're married and you weren't even thinking about the network marketing profession and it was introduced to you. And then lo and behold, one person likes it and the other doesn't. Then you have this fork in the road. At this particular point, it really is going to boil down to this. Love. Love. Love will support you as you evolve. Because love is at the core of evolution. Everything consistently changes. Think about the trees and the leaves on the trees. You know, as it transitions into fall, the color of the leaves change, you know, and it's inevitable that we're going to change. And if a person is not allowing you to change, guess what? They're not allowing you to live. And if your spouse, your significant other loves you, they're going to let you evolve. They want to support you in your evolution. Okay, and they're going to support you through it because guess what? They should be evolving as well. And if they're not, if they're stagnant, yikes, right? Yikes. So listen, speak with one another, communicate with one another. And if you need to seek counseling, you know, if it gets that on that particular level, do that. Okay. And if, you know, they're not permitting you to live, then you got to think about it. You know, you got to keep doing what you're doing. Okay. You do what is right. Be faithful and do what you know is right. Okay. So again, I appreciate your time on tonight here with the Leadership TKO live night show. And so listen, I can't wait, of course, for 9 o'clock. Now, let me tell you what's going on at 9 tonight. Now, many of you probably know I'm connected to an amazing team of people. They live all around the world. And all we're simply doing is building wealth. All we're simply doing is getting access to God's money. If you're connected to God, I'm just going to put this, some of you may not be. If you are someone who is spirit-led and you believe in God, okay, do you have access to his money? Do you have access to it? You know, and if you don't, I encourage you to. Okay. And even if maybe you don't have a relationship with them, but look, you just want to build wealth, generational wealth. I encourage you to get access to that 24 karat gold. Because again, when it comes to this, you need to find out whether this is money or not. Okay. If you connect with someone who shared this with you, we'll give you information to help you to understand whether that Federal Reserve note is actually money or not. We'll educate you. We'll help you understand that. So again, I appreciate you, but if you want to learn more about this money system that we're connected to, get back with the person that shared this with you. We'll give you access to a quick little 8-minute video so you can check that out. Now, also, tonight, we are having a more in-depth presentation that's taking place at 9 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And so it's going to happen on the Zoom platform, and it also may stream onto Facebook, onto many of the timelines of my partners, including my own. All right. So if you want to watch the stream, just make sure your notifications are on so you can join us. Or if you want to get on the Zoom platform, please make sure, number one, that you have the link, which is goldrocks.info. That's number one. And then also get back with the person that shared this stream with you so you can get the password. Because again, Gold Rocks is password protected. Okay. So get the password so you can join us on the platform. So listen, I salute and congratulate those of you who are going to decide, you know what, I'm going to access God's money tonight, and you're going to get your free account so you can start accumulating that real money gold. And for those of you who have questions, yes, can't wait, of course, to answer your questions as well. So listen, I'll be back tomorrow night. We're going to be streaming both places, not only here on my timeline, but also on my fan page as well. We're going to do both. Okay, we're going to be in both places one time. We have different devices. We're going to make it happen. We're going to make it work. We want to alert those on the fan page about what we do. There are about over 14,000 people there around the world. They need access to God's money as well. They need information that's going to help them to grow as leaders. And we, a part of the Leadership TKO family, we're going to help get it to them. So again, thank you so much, everybody. Appreciate your time, your viewership, your listenership. Are those words? I just, you know, see, this is what happens when you do this a lot. You get start to make up words. But thank you so very much. You all be blessed. Look forward to catching you on the platform at 9. So until then, I encourage each and every one of you to think, to speak, and to live leadership. Good night. God bless, and catch you a little bit later.